intra-duodenal part that goes through the wall of the duodenum to open into the duodenal lumen. So extrahepatic biliary tree consisting of gallbladder, cystic duct, right and left hepatic duct, common hepatic duct, and common bile duct. Gallbladder, we know, we can recognize by its pear-shaped structure. Length varies from 7.5 to 12 centimeter, having fundus, body, and neck. And ultimately, the bile drain into the duodenum through the common bile duct, which have the four parts, supraduodenal part, retroduodenal part, infraduodenal part, and intraduodenal part. We have to remember the blood supply of the gallbladder. Mainly, gallbladder is supplied by the most important artery is right hepatic artery. That is, from right hepatic artery, there is cystic artery arises, and cystic artery goes to supply the gallbladder. So gallbladder is supplied by cystic artery that arises from the right hepatic artery. But in some percentages cases, there are an accessory cystic artery, additional cystic artery that arises from the gastroduodenal artery. So it can also, this is important to remember, because in case of cholecystectomy or operation onto the gallbladder, if we forget about the presence of accessory cystic artery and if we fail to ligate this artery, there might be unexpected bleeding from the area. So always we have to ligate the cystic artery and we have to look for any accessory cystic artery before excision of the gallbladder. You can see this is a picture, gross picture of the gallbladder with cystic duct, cystic artery, hepatic artery, and the first and second part of the duodenum. In relation to surgery, one of the anatomical relation is very important. We call it calotes triangle. This is calotes triangle. That is the a triangular area above, that is the liver, below, that is the cystic duct, and to the left, the common hepatic duct and right hepatic duct. So this is the calotes triangle. So what is calotes triangle? It is an anatomical space below the liver. And this is described by the French surgeon, Jean-Francois Calot. It also, it is named as hepatobiliary or cystohepatic triangle. So this is better to remember as calotes triangle. It is bounded below by the cystic duct, above inferior margin of the liver, medially on hepatic duct. Why it is important? Because during cholecystectomy or operation onto the gallbladder, it is necessary to ligate the cystic duct and cystic artery, keeping common bile duct and common hepatic artery intact. So it is very important to identify the boundaries and the contents of the calotes triangle so that we can avoid the injury of the important structure like common hepatic duct, common bile duct, and common hepatic artery. So it contains cystic artery, hepatic artery, and a lymph nodes. Importance, eta bollam, this is an anatomical landmark to identify during cholecystectomy to avoid the injury of the common bile duct. আমরা যদি ক্যালোস ট্রায়াঙ্গেল রিকগনাইজ করতে না পারি, দেয়ার ইজ পসিবিলিটিস অফ ইঞ্জুরি অফ দি কমন বাইল ডাক্ট, মিসটেকেনলি থিঙ্কিং ইট অ্যাজ সিস্টিক ডাক্ট। সো বিফোর লাইগেটিং অর ক্লিপিং সিস্টিক ডাক্ট অ্যান্ড সিস্টিক আর্টারি, উই হ্যাভ টু ক্লিনলি আইডেন্টিফাই দি স্ট্রাকচার্স অফ দি ক্যালোস ট্রায়াঙ্গেল, অ্যান্ড ইন দিস ওয়ে we can avoid the injury to the most important structure. This is the calotes triangle. Above inferior margin of the liver, below cystic duct, on the left side or medially, the common hepatic duct.
Sir, क्यों क्यों सब pending है sir? Joint के लिए खूब भला है तो sir.
नहीं pending.
Except for.
हाँ. Then admit. Yes, sir. The lymphatic drainage of the gallbladder, this is important to understand the pathology of the carcinoma of the gallbladder. How this lymphatic drainage can correlate with the spread of this tumor to the lymph nodes, liver, and systematically. We know from our knowledge of anatomy, the lymphatics from the gallbladder, these are arranged in mainly in the two set, submucosal and subserosal lymphatic channel. So one lymphatic channel or plexus is situated under the serous coat, and another it is situated under the mucous membrane. So these lymphatic channel or vessel drained into a lymph nodes called the cystic lymph nodes or centrillar lymph node that is situated at the junction of the cystic and common hepatic duct. Among from these cystic lymph nodes, these lymphatic vessels go to the hilum of the liver to the celiac lymph nodes. So cystic lymph node theke, the lymphatic channel goes to the celiac lymph node. From celiac lymph nodes, it goes to the paraortic lymph nodes. And some subserosal lymphatic vessel also connect with the subcapsular lymphatic channel of the liver. And this explains the spread of carcinoma of gallbladder to the liver. So carcinoma of the gallbladder can directly go to the liver, can go through the blood bond, can go through the lymphatic channel through the subcapsular lymphatic channel of the liver. So that's why to correlate the lymphatic drainage of the gallbladder is important to understand the spread of malignant tumor from the gallbladder to the system and to the liver. And you know from your knowledge of physiology that bile is being secreted by the liver, and there is certain changes of this bile in the gallbladder. So there is a bit difference in the bile. We call it hepatic bile and gallbladder bile. So bile is produced in the liver and is stored temporarily in the gallbladder. You know, rate of secretion is about 40 ml per hour. Composition, 97% is solid, is water, and only 3% is solid. Among solid, there are bile salt. Primary bile salt is cholic acid and kenodeoxycholic acid, and secondary bile salt, deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid, phospholipid, cholesterol, and bile pigment bilirubin. So these are, in short, the composition of the hepatic bile, that is bile secreted by the liver. And whenever it goes to gallbladder, there are some changes. So what are the function of bile? How it is beneficial or essential for our life? So bile is responsible for emulsification of fat, and it helps in digestion and absorption. So without bile, fatty food cannot be digested properly and cannot be absorbed. In addition to fatty food, bile also, particularly bile salt, also necessary for absorption of the fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E, K. Now, one question is being raised, particularly patients who are coming for cholecystectomy. They ask to the doctor, what will happen after removing of his or her gallbladder. That is, after cholecystectomy, what will be the effect? So if we know the function of the gallbladder, we can correlate with this situation. We can say the correct answer. What would be the effect onto you after this operation? So we know the gallbladder is perform some function, but no of this function is very important for our life. One function is reservoir of bile and to transport it to the duodenum. So after secretion into the, you know, from the gallbladder, from the liver, it passes through the right and left hepatic duct, and in between meal, sphincter of OD remain closed. So bile cannot directly enter into the duodenum. Rather, it will be diverted to storage house of the gallbladder. Gallbladder would accommodate the bile continuously secreted by liver. So gallbladder acts as a temporary reservoir. Then it can perform the concentration of the bile. So far, it is transported from the liver. After reaching the gallbladder, it becomes concentrated 5 to 10 times by active absorption of the water, sodium chloride, and bicarbonate. So there will be corresponding increase in the proportion of the bile salt, bile pigment, cholesterol, and calcium. So water and sodium chloride, bicarbonate will be absorbed, and it creates a corresponding increase in the concentration of the bile salt, bile pigment, cholesterol. Secretion of the mucus. You know, approximately 20 ml per day, mucus is being secreted from the gallbladder lining epithelium. So if bile cannot enter into the gallbladder due to obstruction into neck, after a few days, we can see that gallbladder is distended with mucus, and the source of mucus is, it is being secreted from the lining epithelium of the gallbladder. So gallbladder perform this function, reservoir, concentration of bile, and secretion of the mucus. And after cholecystectomy, all this function will be maintained partly by the common bile duct. So nothing serious will happen. The body or individual will be accustomed with the situation. And after a few months, he or she cannot recognize that she is without gallbladder, because most of the function of the gallbladder will be taken over by the common bile duct. And nothing of this function is very important for maintenance of our life. So after recapitulating few points regarding anatomy and physiology, whenever a patient present with gallbladder disease or hepatobiliary disease, for confirmation of the diagnosis and to correlate with other things, we have to advise some investigations. And the most common investigation is ultrasonogram of the hepatobiliary system and pancreas. Second one is liver function test. ESARA, there are some other investigation that also can help in the diagnosis. So ultrasonogram, probably you know the principle of ultrasonography. Tumra jano shobai. How ultrasonogram? Shomoy ki? How ultrasonogram work or help? Shunte pachho na? Shuna jacche?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, do you heard the name of ultrasonogram?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The ultrasonogram is used in medical science for evaluation of the disease. Sometimes it can show useful in the treatment of disease. Ultrasonogram, many of you might know, that is, ultrasound is produced by piezoelectric movement of the microcrystal. There is a devices where the ultrasound is being produced. And this ultrasound is allowed to pass through a probe into a parts of the body. After passing through the body, it crosses the body tissue according to texture. It can go unimpededly without any obstacle to the liquid, to the air. But whenever it is passing through the solid structure, it is being produced echo. And according to texture of the tissue, the echo varies. That is, if it goes through the fat, it produces less echo. If it passes through the muscle, it produces much more echo. If it passes through the solid organ like liver, spleen, much more echoes. And it passes through the bones or stones, it produces strong echoes. These echoes are being reflected back onto the probe and picked up by the same probe, and it is analyzed in the computer and ultimately gives a pictorial image. Utilizing this principle, ultrasonogram can demonstrate a size of an organ, texture of an organ, any additional pathology in the organ. Could you follow it?
Yes, sir.
So I told you, in ultrasonography, ultrasound is produced by a minor piezoelectric movement of the microcrystal. This ultrasound is allowed to pass through a probe into the different parts of the body. And according to texture of the tissue, the some ultrasound is reflected back in the form of echo. And these echoes are picked up by the same probe, and it is analyzed in the computer, ultimately gives a pictorial image of the organ to be scanned. And this is the principle how ultrasonogram can be helpful in the diagnosis of a disease or in demonstrating the morphology and changes in the morphology of an organ, particularly solid organ. So ultrasonogram, if we do ultrasonogram through the abdominal wall, it is called transabdominal ultrasonography. Anishomai, endoscopic ultrasonogram is also available. We introduce the probe through the mouth, esophagus, stomach, duodenum, and from the duodenum, structure surrounding the duodenum can be assessed. This is called transduodenal sonography. That is a very specialized form of the ultrasonogram. So abdominal ultrasonogram, it is very accurate, readily available, not very expensive, and quick to perform. And you know, this does not give any radiation. So it can be done in all individual, including the pregnant mother. So ultrasonogram is an investigation that is non-invasive, readily available, quick to perform, and can be done even in pregnant mother. But because of presence of excess body fat and intraluminal bile gas, the report may not be always optimally get. So for better result, we have to do the ultrasonogram in empty stomach, in bowel preparation, avoiding excess presence of gas. So in case of gallbladder, ultrasonogram can demonstrate the biliary calculi. Biliary calculi means the stone in the biliary tree. It can demonstrate the size of the gallbladder, whether enlarged or not, or contracted. Thickness of the gallbladder wall. We know thickness of the gallbladder wall is, suppose, 1 to 1.5 centimeter, millimeter, but in case of acute cholecystitis and chronic cholecystitis wall might be more thickened. In acute cholecystitis, it is thickened due to edema. In chronic cholecystitis, it is thickened due to fibrosis. So thickness of the gallbladder wall can be demonstrated by ultrasonogram. The presence of inflammation around the gallbladder can be demonstrated. Size of the common bile duct and its dilatation. Amra jani, the common bile duct is about 4 to 6 millimeter in diameter. But in case of biliary obstruction, the diameter will be increased more than 8 millimeter. And if it is more than 10 millimeter, we certainly say gallbladder bile duct is dilated. The presence of stone in biliary tree, parenchymatous pattern of the liver and pancreas, neoplastic mass. So ultrasonogram will demonstrate the morphology and diseases of the gallbladder, bile duct, liver, and pancreas. In case of stone, they can demonstrate the presence of stone in the gallbladder or in the bile duct. They can say the thickness of the gallbladder wall. They can say diameter of the bile duct. And they can say also the condition of the pancreas and liver. So in this way, they can also give idea regarding the presence of tumor. This is an ultrasonogram. Oh, yes, light, the pointer. Nahin? So, এটা ইউজ করে কখনো ইউজ করেনি can you see the picture
yes sir দেখতে পাচ্ছি
দেখতে পাচ্ছি এখন কি যে করেন হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আচ্ছা মাউস সো this is part of the liver okay this is the liver appears to be more homogeneous. This is wall of the gallbladder. Can you see? Wall
yes,
of
sir.
The gallbladder. The yes, black sir. Area, black area that is lumen of the gallbladder. Within the black lumen, there is a shadow, white shadow. And behind this white shadow, there is a black shadow. This is the sonographic evidence of gall stone or cholelithiasis. Amra boli, gallbladder wall is thickened. It contains one echogenic structure in the lumen, casting posterior acoustic shadow. So this is the evidence or picture, ultrasonographic picture of the gallbladder with stone. This is the stone. Can you follow?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh. Yes, sir.
Achha. Take us. So, Rakan. Koi, you have to know? Admit at a so this is we already mentioned this is this is the gallbladder, and this is the stone. Echogenic structure, that is the posterior acoustic shadow. So we call this the echo pattern of the hepatic parenchyma is normal homogeneous. Gallbladder is normal in size, wall thickness is normal. It contains one or more echogenic structures casting posterior acoustic shadow. And in another picture, we can see bile duct is not dilated. So this is the classical picture for cholelithiasis. Okay.
Sir, ekhane stone ki sa shudhu ektai.
এইখানে ভালো করে দেখলে মনে হয় বলার জন্য একটা বলছি, কিন্তু এটা একটা, এটা একটা, এটা একটা, তিনটা দেখা যাচ্ছে অবভিয়াস, ঠিক আছে? মাঝখানে একটা সেপ্টামের মতো মনে হচ্ছে. সো অ্যাট লিস্ট থ্রি স্টোন ইজ ভিজিবল. ওকে,
ইয়েস স্যার.
এখানে একটা পিকচার হচ্ছে, ইন দিস পিকচার কি বুঝি নাই কি কি বলছে ওরা, কি বলছে? হ্যাঁ, তোরা অপারেশন করবে? আচ্ছা দেখো, অপারেশন যে করে, হ্যাঁ করো. লেট মানে কয়টা বাজে? ওদের অ্যানাস্থেসিয়া ওনাদের সঙ্গে কথা বলো, আধা ঘন্টার মধ্যে রেডি করো. So this is also a picture of ultrasonogram. That is the liver. You can see this is wall of the gallbladder. But within the lumen, you can see there is an echogenic structure, as if it is continuous with the one wall of the gallbladder. But posteriorly, there is no acoustic shadow. So this is a picture of a neoplastic mass in the gallbladder, maybe polyp, maybe other tumor. This is not the stone. So ultrasonogram or sonographically, the difference between stone and tumor, in stone, in addition to echogenic structure, there should be an posterior acoustic shadow, a black shadow posteriorly. But in case of tumor, there will be no such acoustic shadow. Could you follow?
Yes, sir.
This is the wall of the gallbladder. This is the wall of the gallbladder. And this is the echogenic structure. But there is no posterior acoustic shadow behind this echogenic structure. So this is sonographically, there is echogenic structure without posterior acoustic shadow. So here diagnosis will be tumor or polyp. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
OCG, one of the investigation, but it become obsolete nowadays because of the availability of the more useful ultrasonogram. It was available and played an important role in diagnosis about 40-50 years back, oral cholecystogram. Here we can try to visualize the gallbladder and we can demonstrate the presence of stone in the gallbladder. Nowadays it is seldom done because of the availability of the ultrasonogram. This is the OCG picture. You can see this is the gallbladder, and this is the gallbladder. And there is a small diverticula like pockets around the gallbladder. This is called the diverticula. So this is the gallbladder picture with diverticulosis that is being demonstrated by oral cholecystogram. Radioisotope scanning, this is not so important, but sometimes we have to do the radioisotope using technetium-99 at level derivatives of iminodiacetic acid. It is a HIDA scan. hydroxyimmunodiacetic acid. It is injected and taken up by the liver and excreted into the bile and gives visualization. So in acute cholecystitis, a radioisotope scanning shows non-visualization of the gallbladder. So sometimes this may be useful. This is the radioisotope scanning. That is the above shadow, that is the shadow of the liver. Isotope is taken by the liver, and this is shadow of the biliary tree, and this is the shadow of the gallbladder. So this is a normal functioning HIDA scan. One of the investigation is whenever there is obstructive jaundice or there is something within the bile duct, we can do an investigation. We call it ERCP, endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography. That is through an endoscope, upper GI endoscope with side viewing and cannula, the ampulla of Vater is cannulated and soluble contrast injected into the bile, and that provides image of the ductal anatomy of the biliary tree and pancreas. Eta, this is the ERCP. So a tube is being, endoscope is introduced through the mouth. It is cannulated into bile duct and injection is given. It gives visualization of the biliary tree, the left hepatic duct, right hepatic duct, common bile duct, this is the gallbladder. To demonstrate any pathology within this, this retrograde cholangiopancreatography. We can see by ERCP, there is a filling defect in the bile duct that indicate presence of a stone in the common bile duct. Here, there is failure of filling of some parts of the common bile duct. Upper part is filled up, but in between it is not being filled up by the contrast. So it indicates presence of tumor or stricture in the bile duct. So in obstructive jaundice, one of the investigation is ERCP. ERCP not only investigation of for diagnosis, also can be helpful for treatment. Jamon, through ERCP, we can extract the stone. There are multiple negative shadow ERCP shows here, 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 here. So this indicate the stone in the common bile duct. Magnetic resonance cholangiopancreatography, it's a non-invasive demonstration of extrahepatic biliary tree using a magnetic resonance. So instead of ERCP, MRCP can be done for diagnosis, but this cannot be used for therapeutic purpose. Percutaneous transhepatic cholangiography, when obstruction appears to be in the upper part, we can introduce needle into the liver, into the dilated biliary channel, and dye is injected ultimately to demonstrate the upper part of the biliary tree. So this is percutaneous transhepatic cholangiography. It shows dilated intrahepatic biliary tree, and there is obstruction in the upper part of the bile duct. So this is called PTC. This is perioperative cholangiography. Sometimes to sure that bile duct is free of the stone, during cholecystectomy, we introduce a needle into the common bile duct, and then we inject the contrast to see whether this contrast visualizes this part of the common bile duct, and contrast freely entered into the duodenum to exclude that there is no stone. But here you see that after perioperative cholangiogram, there is presence of multiple negative shadow within the common bile duct. This indicates the presence of a stone in the bile duct, which sometimes cannot be palpable, but can only be demonstrated by doing এটা এখন দরকার নেই দিস ইজ এ পোস্ট অপারেটিভ কোলাঞ্জিওগ্রাম সামটাইমস উই ক্যান ডু দ্য সিটি স্ক্যান এন্ড এমআরআই সো উইথ দিস ভিউ দ্যাট ইজ ইফ উই ডু দ্য রিলেভেন্ট ইনভেস্টিগেশন দ্যাট ইজ দ্য এক্সরে অ্যাবডোমেন আল্ট্রাসোনোগ্রাম অফ দি হেপাটোবিলারি সিস্টেম লিভার ফাংশন টেস্ট সামটাইমস ইনভেসিভ ইনভেস্টিগেশন লাইক ERCP PTC, MRCP, CT scan, MRI, all these things can ultimately, can make the diagnosis. Okay, shunte pachho?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So with this few words, tomader kono question ase, any question up to this level? Any question from you?
Sir, gallbladder, sir, jokhon thakbe na, tokhon to sir liver theke par awar to sir 40 ml kore bile production hotei thakbe.
Haan.
Tahole sir, otar jonno ki sir pore body te ki sir kono problem hobe na?
Na, usually bile is necessary for emulsification and digestion of fat for absorption of the fat soluble vitamin. It is not as essential as that of the kidney, heart or lung. Life is possible even absent without the absence of the bile. Our gallbladder perform only a temporary storage function that is not at all very essential. Part of this function will be taken up by the bile duct and partly it is contributed by the bile duct after cholecystectomy. And with time, 2 থেকে 3 মাসের মধ্যে accommodation হয়ে যায়. লিভার সিক্রিশনটাও কমবে বাইল ডাক্টের স্টোরেজটাও বাড়বে এন্ড ইন দিস ওয়ে দি থিংস উইল বি অ্যাডজাস্টেড ওকে
ইয়েস স্যার
আর কোন কোশ্চেন
স্যার স্যার ওই বাইল ডাক্টের ভিতরে স্যার স্টোরেজটা কোথায় হবে স্যার কমন বাইল ডাক্টে যেটা স্যার স্টোর হচ্ছে
আমরা জানি বাইল সিক্রিশন হয় ফ্রম দি লিভার কন্টিনিউয়াসলি ডিউ টু সাম মেকানিজম ইন্ট্রিনসিক মেকানিজম আফটার সিক্রিশন It is stored in the bile duct because in between meal, the lower end of the common bile duct remain closed. Sphincter of Oddi become closed, remain closed. Only in response to fatty food khaile, there is secretion of cholecystokinin and pancreogymin. This cholecystokinin contract the gallbladder and bile duct and relaxes the sphincter of Oddi, allowing the bile to flow into the duodenum. Sutrang, in between meal, bile is usually stored in the extrahepatic biliary tree, mainly in the gallbladder. Our gallbladder na thake, then it will be stored in the bile duct. And whenever sphincter of Oddi will be open after taking food, particularly fatty food, Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Are kono bishoy? Er modde tumra ultrasonogram kibhabe kore, how it is being done, what is the principle ultrasonogram, how it going to interpret the hepatobiliary disease? What are the usefulness of this ultrasonogram? Eta motamoti mone rakhte hobe. Thik ache? Because whenever you will be encountered with gallbladder disease frequently, you have to come across this investigation that is ultrasonogram. This is one of the very useful investigation in diagnosis of gallbladder disease. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Ar kono bishoy? আচ্ছা শোনো তোমরা যে শিডিউলটা দেওয়া হয়েছে অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দিস শিডিউল অল অফ ইউ 100% ট্রাই টু রিমেইন কানেক্টেড এন্ড ডু দ্য ক্লাসেস ওকে
ইয়েস স্যার
উইল কাউন্ট অল দিস অ্যাটেন্ড অর দি ফিজিবিলিটি অফ ইওর অর ফর ইওর অ্যাপ্লিকেশন অর ফর ইওর ফর্ম ফিল আপ উই ডোন্ট নো How long we have to continue this, so you should have to give a due importance to this class also. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So probably you got the routine, and according to this routine, you try to remain connected with these classes. And at the same time, you have to prepare by yourself at your home. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Wish to
thank you, sir.
Remain well, it's healthy. Nice. Okay.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Welcome, salam. Thank you.
Namaskar, sir.
Namaskar.
Namaskar, sir.
Okay, thank you. Wonderful.
রোল কে নিচ্ছে?
জসিম ভাই যেটা দিছে ওই চারটা না ভাই?
হ্যাঁ ওই চারটা।
হ্যাঁ ভাই ঠিক আছে, ওটা আমরা গ্রুপে দিয়ে দিছি ভাই, অ্যাড করে দিব।
এখনো যে অনলাইনে করি নাই তো এখন স্যারের সাথে ক্লাস করতে হয়েছে, যার কারণে এটা হচ্ছে এখান থেকে নিয়ে নিও।
হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আমরা ওই চারটা সহ কাম করবো। ঠিক আছে
আচ্ছা জিলানি ভাই তোমার নাম্বার অ্যাড করে দেওয়া হবে, সমস্যা নেই।
জিপ নিব নাকি?
হ্যাঁ স্যার চারজন আছি।
আপনি কি আসেন নাকি?
ঠিক আছে।